Kenjo, and I am co-supervised by Drs. Ramsey and Colwyn. My project will be looking at the influence of social information on decision making. So, broadly, we get social information from many sources, and this will feed into opinions we make of people, impressions we form, and we consider their intentions. And this will then guide our behaviour during subsequent interactions. So, I'm particularly interested in the strength of an influence that different types of social information may have. More specifically, I'm interested in the influence of social information on our behaviour over time. So, we may form an initial impression, but following an interaction with someone during an actual experience with them, we will get more information, and so we may need to actually update our behaviour in light of our experience over our original belief. So to go into a bit more detail, if you look at the flow of decision-making process, the first thing we look at is the types of social information that we can use as cues for behaviour. So you can look at just an expressive face, or a dynamic scene between people, or just perhaps a written statement, an opinion of someone, or some gossip about them. And we can then look into how this feeds into our impressions we form of people, and then how we would go on to interact with them. So, for example, if you take a face, lots of research has been done on faces. It's thought that we can very quickly attribute different personality attributes to people, one such being trustworthiness. So we will see a person, a picture of someone, and then form some opinion of them, which would then likely affect how we'd interact with them. So if we look at George here, you might think, he looks quite nice, I might trust him in an interaction. But if you were given a picture of him, maybe you might come to a different conclusion about his intentions, and it's likely that you would interact differently with these two people based on a first impression. But I'm more interested in what would happen if, during an interaction with George, he is not trustworthy, he is not reciprocating any of this trusting behaviour that you're showing towards him. How quickly would you be able to update your initial impression to reflect the fact that his behaviour is contrary to your impression? Likewise, is there anything that Donald might be able to do to make people actually trust him? So, once we've provided this information and people have made their initial impression, we can collect data on their perceptions of trustworthiness, likability, and so forth. We can then go on to actually record their behaviour when they interact with the person. So, would they trust them or wouldn't they? This is all well and good, but this is pretty one-directional. An actual interaction involves more than one person and will likely happen over time. So rather than just looking at this one-off process of perception, decision, action, I'd actually like to look more into what happens when we are getting information about the other person, and we may need to update our behaviours to reflect the fact that the other person's behaviour will likely impact on our behaviour. And so through our experience, we'll get new information on this person that may mean we should actually ignore the original social information and update our impression, which should then feed into changing our behaviour. So I'm looking at the effects of experience and learning over time and how that might change our behaviour. So we can do that by providing this social information that actually then through experience turns out to be unreliable, and we will then measure if people are able to actually change their behaviour over time to reflect their experience and not the original social impression that they formed. So I'm going to do this by looking at hopefully different ages of people. Obviously social skills develop through adolescence. Trust is something that emerges through adolescence, so I'm interested to see if different types of social information, be it written, dynamic or face, are affected differently in different age groups, and whether perhaps adolescents are more quickly able to disregard social information as they're used to perhaps a more turbulent environment where social information they see quite quickly is wrong, so they need to change their behaviour. Finally, I would like to also look at people with autism. They have kind of atypical social approach, less socially oriented, so it might be that they, in the first place, don't pay too much attention to the social information anyway, or perhaps they then have a more logical approach to decision making, and they will perhaps be better at updating as they will have a behaviour that reflects their experience rather than just some information they were given before they even met a person. And that's it.
I just had a quick question. So on the slide that you were just talking about, you had your two age groups. So you're interested in 14, 17-year-olds and then 18-plus. Are you planning on splitting that into kind of younger adults, older adults, and then like the elderly? Or are you planning on just kind of looking at 18-plus in general?
I had originally had aspirations to look at the elderly population as well, but I might have been overstretching myself, so perhaps limit it to younger adults. I'm certainly considered that the difference between 17 and 18 might be negligible, so I will try and have some of the 18-plus try and have older, younger adults, and then obviously possibly more age groups further, 15, 16, 17, as a lot of changes take place in a very short amount of time in that bracket.
Hi, thank you. Is this about learning about unreliability or just per se, or is it why, for example, there might be a shared endeavor between yourself and the partner?
So, it's kind of a twofold. The first is the different types of social information, and then there is the kind of that information is unreliable and incorrect information as you go through an interaction with someone. Yes, we will manipulate the context so that the experience differs from your initial impression. In terms of if it's a joint endeavor, I'm looking at using the trust game. So the aim of the game is for both people to work together to both maximize their profits or rewards. But I haven't considered specific manipulations of whether people will be truly working on a joint endeavor or just think that they are.
Okay. So there's some stuff where people have looked at sort of matching these games where you're playing with a partner, and sometimes the partner provides reliable information. And they've tried to sort of model it from a reinforcement learning perspective. So they're effectively back people who have very independent objectives. Sometimes your partner will provide you with reliable information, sometimes you won't. And that might be relevant to your project.
Yeah, definitely. I've not come across a match of any one, but I will look it up.